This is Mission Control Houston. We're getting close to wrapping up today's ISS update as the crew continues their work for their Friday afternoon activities. The crew has had a pretty busy week this week with a variety of different experiments and maintenance work on board the International Space Station. Burbank spent some time earlier this week swapping out some parts of what's called an amine swing bed. The space station itself has a fairly large-sized carbon dioxide removal assembly on board. This amine swing bed is a smaller, more efficient test version of a similar system that would scrub the air on board the space station. So it is a project run out of the Johnson Space Center here in Houston. They've tested it in labs here, so what better way to test it out than just putting it on board the station and running it there and seeing how it works. So Burbank swapped out some parts of that earlier this week and then got that amine swing bed back up and running. While he was doing that, Don Pettit was working on an experiment called Burning and Suppression of Solids, or BASS. He did a few different test runs of that particular experiment, which takes a look at how things burn and how flames react to being in space. Fire detection and protection and suppression is an important piece of flying aboard a spacecraft. This BASS experiment takes a look at how different things burn and how those fires could be put out. There's a theory about how you would aim a fire extinguisher at the base of the flame, because that is where basically the flame is born. That's where air gets fed into it. But of course, that may not react the same way up in space and in the absence of gravity and the absence of air. So this BASS experiment basically takes a look at that to find out how those fires could be put out. Burbank also spent some time himself inside the Quest airlock scrubbing those EMU suits. Those are the space suits that the U.S. astronauts use anytime they step outside the station. That is some routine work that he took care of, basically just pumping some water and some other items into those suits, cleaning them out, making sure that there's no bacteria growing and that they're up and running as expected. Burbank himself, as well as Shkaplerov and Ivanishin, getting ready to come home at the end of the month on April 27th. So that particular portion of the Expedition 30 crew has begun their deorbit preparations in earnest, getting everything together, making sure that they've got everything ready to go for their return on April 27th. The crew will be closing the hatches at midnight Central Time, right on the dot, April 27th. And they'll be landing northeast of Arkalyk there in Kazakhstan at 6:45 a.m. Central Time, again on April 27th. The crew also spent some time talking with media here on the ground. They had their traditional crew news conference earlier this week as they spoke with various media here in Houston and around the country about life on board the space station. There you see Don Pettit, Dan Burbank on the far right-hand side. Andre Korpers there in the middle. They talked about all the different research activities that they have going on, the upcoming SpaceX Dragon demonstration mission that Don Pettit and Korpers will be an important part of, and also Dan Burbank's thoughts on the fact that he's in his final 2 weeks aboard the station. So the crew spent about a half hour or so talking with media about those activities. The crew as a whole also getting ready to say goodbye to the Progress 46. That spacecraft has been docked with the station there on the pier's docking compartment since January. It's time coming to a close, so they've been packing it up with final items and trash that they don't need. That Progress 46 will undock from the pier's docking compartment coming up on April 19th. It'll back away, spend a few days doing some engineering tests, and then it will be deorbited into a fiery destructive deorbit into the Earth's atmosphere. And finally, the big news of the week is that Don Pettit, Andre Korpers getting ready to welcome the Dragon spacecraft from SpaceX coming up on April 30th. They began 2 weeks worth of training activities on Monday, taking a look at the onboard laptops at the robotic workstation there in the Destiny Laboratory. There you see animation of what it's going to look like once Dragon arrives at the station about 10 meters away. Don Pettit will be the one in charge using the station's robotic arm, extending it out from the U.S. segment, grabbing onto Dragon, and pulling it on in to the bottom side of the Harmony node. And that will be a major milestone for not only NASA, but the SpaceX team there that has been working for several years on this Dragon, as well as the Falcon 9 spacecraft. Of course, for all the latest on this upcoming mission, we invite you to log on to www.nasa.gov/SpaceX. And of course, we will have all the latest for you coming up on Monday as we bring you the pre-flight briefing from here at the Johnson Space Center after the conclusion of the flight readiness review here in Houston. We thank you for joining us this week. The crew has been very busy. We invite you to join us again next week as Expedition 30 continues.